What a very busy last 4 hours this has been, started by a crazy beginning with Roman Rusinov, the Russian driver, backing the whole of the field up. How on earth we didn't get more damaged race cars from this, I've no idea. There's certainly bits of bodywork and bullets from the LMP3s being removed, plucked out of the rear tail sections of these cars. Finally, we did get up and running, and Roman Rusinov will have to soak up a drive-through penalty because of his part in all of that. We reached turn one. Wasn't quite contact between the two United Autosports car, but on cold tyres, Nicolas Jammer made a bit of a schoolboy error, which he owned up to in interview with Hayley Edmonds later on. And the cold Goodyear tyres spat him off into the gravel trap. Needed to wait a little bit longer for a few more corners before he really started to up the ante. And a safety car would be scrambled in order to recover Nicolas Jammer's car. There was also drama later on this very same lap as the safety car boards were displayed. Contact between Sally Yolich in the Racing Team Turkey prototype and the Dragon Speed Orica, and it meant that Henrik Hedman, en route to retirement eventually, would be facing oncoming traffic at the turn 14 and 15 chicane. Early leader in LMP3 was Laurence Khor. He really did scamper away from the rest of the baby prototypes. And this is a great moment for Team WRT, our eventual winners. Louis Delatraz slithering his way up the inside, a gap that wasn't really there. He had to, well, Roman Rusinov rather defensive on the run down to turn one, but that wasn't going to hold back the young Swiss. And that was the point where he took the race lead. Pit stops for the GTs took place about an hour into the race. And it was at this point that the 80 car from Iron Lynx would start to stamp its authority on the race. Stops as well, including this one for G-Drive Racing. Their team cars double stacked in the pits. Well, there should normally be enough room for two cars, but as one was released, it cleaned out the wheel of the other. There was contact between Jean-Maria Bruni and Claudio Schiavoni. Schiavoni in the yellow and black Ferrari gave Bruni a bit back on the exit as well. And Bruni, you'll notice, has managed to pluck out a fair old section of the Ferrari's rear diffuser. Left Proton Competition scratching their heads a little bit. What was that bodywork? Well, it was a bit of Ferrari that they'd never seen before. Rahel Fry, what a drive from her, from seventh place up to fourth ultimately for Iron Lynx. And that pink and black car really did take some holding back, overtaking Felipe Larza and Jody Fannin amongst others. The 80 car takes victory then for Miguel Molinar, together with his teammates Matteo Cressoni and Rino Mastronardi. It's a win in LMP3 for Cool Racing, and a first ever victory for Team WRT. Robert Kubica, Louis Delatraz and Yi Fei Ye are the round one winners in the ELMS.
Fantastic stuff. And first, as we said earlier in the broadcast, first Belgian winner of a European Le Mans Series, All Le Mans Series race as a team. First Chinese driver to win. First Polish driver to win. And I believe the first Swiss driver to win since 2017 in Delatraz.
Yeah.
So quite
a number of firsts.
Yeah, really, really
there.
Was. Excellent stuff. And great race at LMP3 at the end there. That chase down of the DKR engineering car, I'm sure they'll be disappointed with finishing off the podium. Finally, I think fifth it was for DKR engineering's Alan Berg, Lawrence Herr. But in GTE, the usual spectacular action.
Same for the team. So WRT 25, Panis Racing 18, United 15, G-Drive Racing get the extra point and the fourth place points, which is 12 plus 1, comes to 13, and they will be fourth in the championship. Duquesne, with their sixth place finish, get 8.
Departure.
Well, speaking of Pro-Am, it will be their podium next, and a chance to catch up with the winning team and at least one of their drivers. The opening weekend, third position going to the slightly rearranged driver lineup at Spirit of Race. David Perel added in to join Matt Griffin and Duncan Cameron. Drivers' trophy for the teams, 25 go to Cool Racing. RLRM Sport for second place get 18. And into Europol competition, the Polish squad for 15 points. Well, doesn't that set things up nicely for the rest of the ELMS campaign? Join us in a month's time.